Separating variables is a great technique for solving ordinary differential equations that can be written in a specific form, and that is in the form dy dx equals a ratio of a function of x and a function of y. Now, it's called separating variables because in some sense I've separated the variables x and y. I have on the top g of x, a function of x alone, and on the bottom f of y, a function of y alone. Now, I invite you to think a little bit about how specific or how restrictive it is to assume that I can write this right-hand side as a ratio like this. Okay, now how is this going to help us solve differential equations? Well, I'll describe to you now a trick. And I put trick here in quotations because I don't mean trick in the sense of a magic trick. I mean trick in the sense of a mnemonic trick, a device for remembering this process. Even though what I'll describe seems a little unjustified, I assure you that we can justify it completely. Okay, so what's the first thing we do? Well, we rewrite this ordinary differential equation in the form f of y dy equals g of x dx. Okay, so that's like multiplying both sides by dx and multiplying both sides by f of y. Seems a little funny to multiply by dx, but just bear with me. So what we have here looks like two integrands, looks like things that I can integrate. So let's integrate them. So I'll put some integral signs in front of this, and I have the integral of f of y dy and the integral of g of x dx. Now let's actually carry out those integrals. So I find an antiderivative of little f, call that capital F, and an antiderivative of little g, call that capital G, and after integration I get capital F of y equals capital G of x. Okay, now what? Well, in some sense, I could be done. I could say, well, this is the solution to the differential equation. But since y maybe appears in some complicated fashion on the left-hand side, I may not have a function y of x. So if I was to leave it like this, I would call it an implicit solution. On the other hand, I could solve for y in terms of x, and then I would call it an explicit solution.